Welcome, brothers. I'm making this video to address the sacrifice of one Thomas Ball. I say sacrifice because, in the thick of his frustration, with the courts bullying him, his wife keeping his children away from him, and being unemployed yet still owing child support for children he cannot see, he self-immolated, a testimony to the figurative anal screwing you can expect as a man from government and feminist-minded women. His protest was apparently modeled after the burning Buddhist protest against South Vietnam. Oh, by the way, speaking of Vietnam, let me not forget to point out he was a Vietnam veteran as well. Now, the mainstream media, of course, won't give this story a spotlight, and the news outlets that did cover this still had a feminist or anti-male slant to their stories. To the media, Mr. Ball was abusive to his children, had a junky house which reflects his cluttered manifesto, and was antisocial and didn't talk amongst neighbors, was without a job for a couple of years, owed thousands in back child support, and was troubled and maybe dangerous. But in reality, Thomas Ball is simply frustrated and overwhelmed by the extraordinarily biased family court system. He's in pain because he loves his children very much and isn't able to spend a glance of time with them. He felt the only way to be heard was to take the actions he did. A quick side note, as a Christian myself, I by no means approve of suicide, but the message behind his actions are clear and hold meaning. Therefore, this meaning must be presented. In the video Final Justice Movement used in their coverage of the story, something the narrator of WMUR 9 News said burned me up inside. I'm gonna play the clip for you.
And a lengthy battle over custody of Ball and his wife's three children.
Did you catch that? So apparently, now the children aren't Ball's and his ex-wife's. They're simply hers. If you think I'm making a big deal out of nothing, you're not understanding the significance of that statement. It only affirms that what we've been saying for quite some time now, which is men are disposable and have no rights. It's part of the feminist manifesto by which they believe the father should be excluded from the children's lives along with his influence. This done while the mothers take care of them and everyone else supports the mother and children. The feminist mind is a very sick and twisted one, so much so that an article which was created on Wikipedia about Thomas Ball was marked for deletion by a feminist from Canada. As usual, all the links to all the references will be posted in the description. These lowlife scum are trying their best to keep this story out of the spotlight and out of reach to everyday people. They're kind of like coverage or comment fascist, if you will, seeking to destroy any type of content disagreeing with and contradicting their likes, beliefs, and lifestyle. But I digress. Some quotes from Ball's manifesto are as follows. Quote, "I'm tired of being bullied for being a man." Quote, end quote. Another was, quote, "I have three things to say to my children. First, Daddy loves you. Second, you are my three most favorite people in the world. And last, that you are to stick together no matter how old you get or how far apart you live. Because it is like Grandma always said, the only thing you really have in this world is your family." End quote. And another quote before that in the manifesto was, "Now, thanks to the United States government, neither we nor our children have that." End quote. The gender bias in the family courts must stop. It is a well-known fact that a divorced father is 10 times more likely to commit suicide than a divorced mother, and 3 times more likely to commit suicide than a married father, according to Los Angeles divorce consultant Jane Major. She also stated, quote, "Divorced men are often devastated by the loss of their children. It is a little known fact that in the United States, men initiate only a small number of the divorces involving children. Most of the men I deal with never saw their divorces coming, and they are often treated very unfairly by the family courts." As MRAs, we must address these issues and scrutinize the outcomes if we are to ever make a change towards true equality. This is Crazy 316. I'm out.